Hi, I'm Josh from AWS.
Hi, I'm Enoch Daniel from Granicus, and this is my architecture.
So, Enoch, Granicus is a platform for digital experiences for governments. Can you tell me a little bit more about some of the unique challenges you face and how this architecture helped with those challenges?
Definitely. So this architecture is all about one of our civic engagement platform, which is called GovMeetings. And what they do today is manage and maintain agenda and meeting solutions. And clerk today in government spend a considerable amount of time, not just for organizing and preparing for the meeting, but also summarizing the meeting. And that's where we thought we have to build a solution to make sure that the meetings can be summarized in a more comprehensive way and even more accurately.
Yeah, that sounds like a lot of work to take all those meetings and summarize everything. So sounds like a really useful platform. So I see meeting application here. Are there more than one meeting application you work with?
That's a good question. So let's assume this is meeting app A, but we also have a meeting app B and a meeting app C. So we want to make sure that we build a application agnostic solution. So this can be reused in different meeting applications in the future.
Yeah, so it stays flexible and extensible. That's great. And then, so can you tell me more about the flow that goes in this API gateway up through this Lambda function?
Yeah, so what happens is clerk today from the meeting application can request for a summarization of a meeting. So when that request comes in, what we do is we store the metadata information in DynamoDB, and we store the transcripts in S3.
Awesome. So you have these two different types of data stores. You know, you have the transcripts up here, you said, and then DynamoDBs for the metadata. How did you settle on DynamoDB specifically as your data store here?
That's a good question. So currently we have about 600 plus meetings customers, and we have to not only store the meeting metadata, but also store the customer metadata. And with the advantage of a low latency and serverless model, we wanted to go with the DynamoDB so it can process the data across all customers.
Yeah, you really leaned into serverless here, and the latency story here makes a lot of sense. So here, this seems like the sort of the head of the operation, the brain of the operation here, this step functions workflow. Can you tell us a little bit more about how this map parallelization box and this Lambda function work together?
Yeah, I'm excited to dive into this. So when we store the S3, the transcripts into S3, it kicks off a step functions workflow. And what it really does is it'll take this massive 500 plus pages long transcript, and it'll divide that into agendas and then summarize them using Bedrock. And this is where the map parallelization comes into place, where because we are dividing that into different agendas, we can parallelly run them.
Okay, so it's not just the concurrency of Lambda itself, that service, it's actually parallel use of different types of functions for the agendas, right? So you're actually parallelizing in addition to the scale and concurrency for Lambda. Is that a big factor in why you chose Lambda for this?
That is exactly the point. So we wanted to make sure that we can choose Lambda because of the way we architected it. Because, as you think about sending 500 plus pages of content into Bedrock, you obviously run out of tokens and everything. So we wanted to make sure we manage that. At the same time, it's also useful for our customers because we are going to summarize at the agenda level and not at the entire transcript level. So that's where the advantages comes into play.
Yeah, that makes sense. You brought up Bedrock, so I want to move to that piece now. Bedrock allows for different types of foundational models. Was that a big factor? Why did you choose Bedrock, and have you experimented with different models?
Yeah, that's where the fun happens, right? So I love talking about Bedrock models. So initially, when we tried with the Cohere model and Claude V2 model, when Claude V3 was out, we swapped it out with the Claude V3 model. And what we saw was it's better performance, better results. So we want to make sure our platform can switch between different models.
Yeah, that's great. So you actually have this effect where you have this agnostic and flexible platform over here for the meeting applications and what type of data is coming in. But then you also have this flexibility agnostic model platform where you can adapt to new models. So you kind of have flexibility on both sides.
That's exactly right. So you got the point. So we want to make sure that our models are agnostic too, because with the models are evolving every day. And we want to make sure that we can with configuration, choose the right model we want at the right time.
So you have this S3 bucket here and Lambda. Can you tell me more about these pieces?
After we summarize each agenda item, what we do is we use this Lambda to aggregate all the summaries. So we produce one summarization document, and we store that into the S3 bucket.
So that's what ultimately the customer is going to get back, is that aggregated summary in this bucket.
That is exactly true.
And then is that how they get it back there, this last Lambda function?
Yeah, you got the point. So what happens is the application can request for the status and the summary. And if the process is done and if the status is processed, and then they get the summary from this Lambda. And another intermediate step that we also do is once this process is done, we kind of preserve those status in Amazon DynamoDB as well.
So you come back and you update that table.
Yeah.
And then you're able to keep everything tracked for the results as well.
That is exactly.
Yeah. Well, this is a great architecture and a really cool use of Bedrock. So thank you so much for your time today.